Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. It's another time for us to have another daily dose. This is a booster for us to begin our day right. I know some people watch it early in the morning, some people during the day, and some people even during the night. But you know what? It is supposed to encourage you. It's supposed to encourage your spirit and be able to keep you in the Word of God and be able to help you walk in line with the Word of God. This morning, I want to thank you for giving me an opportunity, or this day, I'd like to thank you for giving me an opportunity to share the Word of God with you. And I pray that this Word will be able to make a difference in your life. So I want to share with you from Proverbs chapter number 3. Proverbs chapter number 3, verses 5 and verses 6. And it says this: trust in the Lord with the whole of your heart. Now you've got to understand, you can never trust somebody unless you can rely upon them. If I am not reliable, then I cannot be trusted. So we are being told to trust in the Lord with the whole of our hearts. In other words, we can rely upon God, we can be confident upon God, and we can be assured in God that He is God and He's going to be who He said He's going to be. So here we are reminded to trust in the Lord with the whole of our hearts. You know, somebody might have a hard time trusting the Lord. And you know what? I don't blame you for trusting the God whom you do not see. But that is why we walk by faith, and therefore we trust Him as a result of our confidence in Him. Therefore, in order for you to be able to trust the Lord, you need to be able to submit yourself. Just submit yourself and say, God, if this is who you say you are, I will believe you for your word, and I want to see you do your word. And if you do your word, that will give me some confidence. That will give me some trust in you. Therefore, trust in the Lord with the whole of your heart. And then he goes on to say this: do not depend on your own understanding. So while you're trusting in the Lord, he's saying don't depend on your own understanding. He did not say don't listen to your understanding. He's saying you have an understanding, but just don't fully rely on your understanding, because when you trust in the Lord, He is leading you, and His leading sometimes will go beyond your understanding. And therefore, trust in Him with the whole of your heart, and lean not or depend not to your own understanding, because your understanding can fail you, but God can never fail you. And therefore, He is giving Himself for you and saying, I will never fail you. Keep on trusting in me with the whole of your heart. You can do what you want to do, but understand this: as long as you do not depend on your understanding 100%, I will be able to help you. Sometimes things can happen in your life that what you have learned cannot allow you to trust in the Lord. But he's saying, you know what? Depend on me more than you depend on your understanding. Because the understanding you have was given to you by mankind. But God says, I can supersede the understanding of man and give you a supernatural understanding. Therefore, trust in the Lord with the whole of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. Then in verse 6 he says, seek His will in all you do, and He will show you which path to take. Now you see, if you rely on your understanding, then your understanding can only keep you in certain paths. But God is saying, when you trust in me with the whole of your heart and lean not to your own understanding, then this is what He says will do. I will show you which path to take, because you don't know which path to take. For example, I can give you is, let's say you want to pursue a career in life. And you don't know which career you want to pursue in life. I'm going through that with my daughter right now. I'm asking, do you know what you want to do? She's like, I don't know what I want to do. And she'll mention quite a few things that she'd like to do. Well, this is a perfect example that she needs to be applying in her life. And we've gone through this. You need to trust in the Lord with the whole of your heart and lean not to your own understanding. Sometimes people lean on their own personality. That, no, this is not my personality. I cannot do this. Says who? You see, that is what man has taught you. And therefore, you are limiting yourself to your understanding, but God can take you far above, beyond your understanding. Because that personality, God can work on it and can make you become somebody whom you thought you're never going to be. And therefore, we need to understand, when we seek Him, He's going to guide us and show us which path to take as we are trusting in Him. So this day, I'd like to encourage you. Trust in the Lord. Lay all your weight upon the Lord, and everything you do, seek Him for guidance,
And he will show you which path to take. Just because you're so much comfortable in taking a specific path does not mean that you ought to take that path today or you ought to take that path tomorrow. Why? Because he says, I will show you which path to take. And therefore, let's trust God. Let's let God be God and let us let him show us what to do so we can live triumphantly. Some of us are facing issues today in life because we are not seeking the face of God on what path to take. We are so much used to our understanding on what to do that we keep on doing it. And even though we keep on doing it, we are now cruising instead of us being able to run and increase our speed because we are not seeking his face anymore. We are so much used to whatever we are doing. Ask the Lord, is this what you want me to do today? Is this the path that you want me to take regarding to this? If you do that, he will show you which path to take. Therefore, I'd like to encourage you, remember, seek his face and he'll show you which path to take. That is because you trust in him. Therefore, you stay blessed and have a wonderful day.